So it's like, you know, me stealing your phone, then you come and complain to me and I judge your complaint. So that's ridiculous. Of course, there are reforms to be done. That's why I'm here. And that is being done slowly. It is slow, a slow process because we are trying to change a system which has been set since 1954 and never changed. And now we are looking at best practices from around the world, engaging with everybody. It's a slow process, but although it is slow, it is built on good foundation, so it should be good. Oh, a lot. You see, there are several types of reform. In fact, I categorize it into four. First are reform which could be done without changing any law, any regulation. Reforms like making it more convenient for people to vote, easier for orang kurang upaya. You know, we prepare ramps, wheelchair, buggies for older people. And it doesn't require any kind of change on rule or of the rules or of the law, so I can do that now. Then, of course, we have the second reform, which will require amendment to regulation or rules. Okay, under the law, I can make rules and regulation, and it will just have to be laid before the parliament. No need approval. Tak payah undi on the regulation. Third reform is where we need to change the law. Now that require drafting of new law or amendment of current law, that requires voting in the parliament. So that's a third type, which is slightly more difficult than the first two. The fourth one, which is more difficult, are reform which require amendment to the constitution. That require two-third majority, and as we all know, our government now do not have two-third majority. But nevertheless, the 18-year-old amendment, the automatic voter registration amendment, those require constitutional amendment, and yet it was pushed through with 100% vote.
Ahli yang tidak bersetuju, tiada.
In the bucket list are a lot, actually. New election system, whether we want to maintain the first past the post or whether we want to go the European way, the proportionate representation way, yeah. Then, of course, revamping the SPR. There must be a nomination agency to nominate the next chairman, to nominate the next members. And probably this nomination agency can even invite application from citizens to become chairman, to become member of SPR. Yeah, so that's on my bucket list. The next one, I think, is the establishment of an independent institution to hear objection against whatever we do. The current system is we do redirection, we display it, the public will come and object to us. And then we will hear the objection against ourselves and decide. So it's like, you know, me stealing your phone, then you come and complain to me and I judge your complaint. So that's ridiculous. So yeah, I would like to have to see an independent institution to hear objection against the SPR and against whatever we do. There are various other reforms. Be patient, but they're coming.